300 miles and he would never get over. I can't get over because I can't pass because I can see the car in front of the truck still. Oh, he got, he's like, oh, wait, wow, he actually got over. Surprising. I'm actually, I'm glad I got that on camera. Nobody knew how to drive the speed limit. We're all doing 55 to 70. Just to show that I was courteous, I waved at him. Getting over. Because he is a slower truck. And I probably ought to get over too. Always get messed up up here going into Austin. Section, there's only two lanes before you get to the elevated. Should never have passed the Penske truck if he knew he was going to exit. If he decided to exit right at the last second, then that's bullshit. Stupid people. Oh, like the post I made on Facebook this morning. That pedal on the right side. If you're on the driver's side and you're in America and you're not driving a postal vehicle, the pedal on the right side of the floorboard on your side, the driver's side, is called the gas pedal. If you push it down all the way to the floor, your car takes off like a bat out of hell. You can speed up faster than me. I don't know how many people coming on the interstate or on the loop that I was on going around San Antonio had more than enough time to step on the gas pedal to get in front of me, but no, they had to slow down. I mean, they're right there at my cab door. How hard to push on the gas pedal to get out in front of me? No, but they had to slow down. Then they had to, then they had to slow down for 50 feet, 48 foot of trailer. Well, hell, more than that, probably 50 foot, 58 feet. 10 feet of tractor and 48 feet of trailer. Instead of just speeding up the extra 10 feet to get around me, and what the screwed up thing is, that same guy, 1 mile before he needed to get off, passes me on the left, cuts in front of me, and then hits his brakes, so I have to pass him on the left, and then he exits. It's like nobody knows where their exit is until they're on top of it. Thank you.
him.
Yep. All new fandangled with barbecue. Come on, people. Quiet. Just stay in your lane. Just because a lane is moving quicker than the other lane doesn't mean you're going to get any further down the road. All you do is cause congestion. That pickup up there. Oh, should I go? No. No. Should I go? No. No. Yeah, I can't make up his mind which way he wants to go. And this car up in front of me, you're not driving a truck, buddy. You can stop in 10 feet. Oh, wait, what is it, about 30 feet? Is it 30 feet for a vehicle? And 300 feet for me. That's a football field length, people. If you don't know what how long a football field length is, go out to your local high school and stand at the zero. Oh, you're going to go there. Stand at the zero, and then have your other friend stand at the other end on the other zero. That's 300 feet. Hey, there's a football field. Yeah, that's 100 yards, people. It's 300 feet. And if the road is wet, double that. 600 feet. Now, if I'm heavy, heavier than I am right now probably, add another 150 feet. Three lanes is not enough, people. Of course, if you build two more on, I mean, they got room for two more. If they put two more on either sides, it's still gonna be backed up in a year. Enough space for two more lanes over there on the right, underneath the bridge. Like I said, two more lanes, it'd be backed up. It's going to be like this in 2 years after they open that up. Oh, maybe they only paved for one and they got to have a breakdown lane. Screw the breakdown lane. Just make an extra lane. Porta potty doors open. Listening.